Okay, it has some of the enclosures and grills painted. Now the ones here at the bottom have two coats. These ones, this is the first coat. And these are the insides getting painted on these few. It's winter, it's January. Saturday morning. And here's the paint that I use. Yeah, and it's cold up here. The sun's about to come up over the hill. Here's the bird cage that I built. Now check out how cold it is. I don't know if this is exactly accurate. I thought this was accurate, but I know that it's 12 degrees here. Yeah, people try to say that, oh, you can't paint in the cold. You know, I've been doing this for years. Probably at least 5 years I've been painting all sorts of items during the winter, in the freezing, below freezing temperatures, and everything's came out great. It's the paint that you had to use. And my friends, this is the best paint ever. This stuff right here. You have to get the shiny can stuff, but don't cheap on the other stuff. This is the good stuff. Makes everything look good. So yeah, I really enjoy looking at these freshly painted silver aluminum speakers, grills. Let's take a look at one that I have going on. This is just a sample one. Now, I'm not really sure if that's gonna be it, but the way that the height and the angle, I think it's gonna be cool. It'll shoot sound out way out here. They're kind of camouflage. I think that overall, having three more included with this is gonna look pretty good. Got the speaker grill for the cabinet painted glass black. Lawnmower parts all loaded up. So let's go take it to the shed and install this. We made it. Okay guys, check this out. I'm gonna paint this door. This is where the radio is gonna go, and this is the speaker. Yellow. Now I've already primed it with flat black. So I have this yellow, RustOleum oil base. Now check this out. I'm gonna brush this on this door here. So the way I do it, all my brush strokes are gonna go up and down. Okay, so I have a used container. It's already yellow. I painted my office. I'm just gonna try to lay it on here and build it up. Keeping all my brush strokes going up and down. Fingers off, call it a day. Okay, we're back in here. Guess what I got today? I just got a brand new Bogan receiver right here. Well, it's not brand new. It's used, it's new to me. Had a good deal on Craigslist. I was on my way home. I stopped by, they hooked me up, and it works great. So now I have three. Now remember when I was talking about that bird that I was gonna get? Well, I got him. Let's go take a look. I'll show you him real fast. Here he is, he's pretty sweet. Well, here's the new door I put on. That's one coat of paint. It came out just like this. The distressed look. Man. Flat black primer. Check that out. I really like that. Some vent holes. This is where it's gonna sit. Yeah, is that cool looking or what? So. This is the feed bin shed. I wasn't trying to go too fancy, so this is, I think it's going to look cool with the distressed look. Yeah, but it really makes a difference when you thin down your LB's paint. Well, they're painted. That's how many I have. Well, I have a few more. There's already a couple mounted. See one here. Mounting one here.